I'm going to turn the level call if everyone is ready to go.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We are so very pleased that you have chosen to join with us for the presentation of Stories of the Savior.
My colleague and I have been discussing the birth of Jesus, and we have decided that it doesn't really start in the New Testament.
Quite right, you see. It actually started at the beginning.
And that is exactly where we begin. The beginning.
Yes, at creation to be exact.
You may be wondering, what does the birth of Jesus have to do with creation?
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being by Him, and apart from Him, nothing came into being that has come into being. In Him was life, and life was the light of men. John chapters 1, verses 1 through 4. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld His glory. Glory as of the only begotten from the Father, full of grace and truth. John chapter 1, verses 14. And the man and his wife hid themselves from the
Where are you?
In the garden. I was afraid, so I hid myself.
Have you eaten from the tree where God commanded you not to eat? What is this you have done?
The serpent deceived me and I ate.
Genesis chapter 3, verses 8 through
13. Sounds like a blame game to me.
Yes, but by the disobedience, the human race now needs a savior. That's why we wanted to do this presentation today.
Ah, stories of the savior. Now I understand, because we are telling people about the different stories in the Bible and the story of the Savior.
Exactly. I have this chart that can help us along the way.
Fancy!
I know.
So, who's next?
Matthew chapter 24, verses 37 through 39. For For Christ also died for sins once and for all, the just for the unjust, in order that he might bring us to God, having been put to death in the flesh, but made alive in the Spirit, in which he also went and made proclamations to the Spirit now in prison, and once, who were once disobedient, when the patience of God kept waiting in the days of Noah during the construction of the ark, in which a few, that is, eight persons, were brought safely through the water. And corresponding to that, baptism now saves you, not the removal of dirt from the flesh, but an appeal for God for a good conscience, through the resurrection of Jesus Christ. 1 Peter chapter 3, verses 18 through 21.
So, you have a story, and so does Noah. Who else?
Thank you.
great, 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 really great grandma.
I wish you could say it like that.
The angel of the Lord called to Abraham a second time from heaven and said,
by myself I have sworn, declares the Lord, because you have done this and have not withheld your son, your only son, I will surely bless you, and I will surely multiply your offspring as the stars of heaven and as the sand that is on the seashore. Your offspring shall possess the gate of his enemies, and in your offspring all the nations of the earth shall be blessed because you have obeyed my voice. If you belong to Christ, then you are Abraham's offspring, heirs according to promise.
Galatians. Galatians chapter 3, verse 29. The book of the genealogy of Jesus Christ, son of David, the son of Abraham. Matthew chapter 1, verse 1.
But they also said that Jesus came from David. Should we go on to him next?
Yeah, what about David? I think he did. What did he have? What did he get away?
A sling.
I think it was a slingshot.
It's a slingshot.
Where did he get it?
Jesus came from the line of David.
And that leads us to up to the afterbirth of Jesus.
We skip a lot of people in the Bible who have stories of the Savior.
Yes, but we should every one of them. We would be the second coming of Jesus.
That makes sense. I'll probably get hungry.
We are going to live off the people who have a perfect picture of the Savior. Let's start with Mary's story.
She's the best place to start when discussing the actual birth of Jesus. Her story was a very deep and personal one.
Now, in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city in Galilee called Nazareth to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph, of the descendants of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And coming in, he said to her, but she was greatly troubled by this statement and kept pondering what kind of salutation this might be. Luke chapter 1, verses 26 through 29. And the angel said to her,
do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. His kingdom will have no end.
Luke chapter 1, verses 30-33.
Mary's story starts with her being told that she has been chosen to be the mother of the Savior. This is where John's story is started as well.
John's story started before he was even born.
In Luke chapter 1, verses 13 through 17, it was written,
do not be afraid, Zacharias, for your petition has been heard. Your wife Elizabeth will bear you a son, and you shall give him the name John. You will have joy and gladness, and many will rejoice at his birth. For he will be great in the sight of the Lord, and he will drink no wine or liquor. He will be filled with the Holy Spirit all while yet in his mother's womb. He will turn back many of the sons of Israel to the Lord their God. It is he who will go as a foreigner before him in the Spirit, and the power of Elijah to turn the hearts of the fathers back to the children. He will turn the disobedient to the attitude of the righteous, so as to make ready a people prepared for the Lord.
Luke chapter 1, verses 39 through 44. Now, at this time, Mary arose and went the case to the hill country, to a city of Judah, and entered the house of Zacharias and greeted Elizabeth. And it came about that when Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the baby leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. And she cried out with a loud voice and said,
Elizabeth, blessed is the fruit of your womb. How has it happened to that the mother of my Lord shall come? When the sound of your greetings reached my ears, the baby leaped in my womb for joy.
In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that a census be taken of all the inhabited earth. This was the first census taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone was on his way to register for the census, each to his own city. Joseph also went up from Galilee, from the city of Nazareth to Judea, the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and family of David, in order to register along with Mary, who was engaged to him, and was with child. While they were there, the days were completed for her to give birth. And she gave birth to her firstborn son, and she wrapped him in clothes and laid him in the manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Luke chapter 2, verses 1 through 7.
That didn't mention it, innkeeper.
It does say that Mary gave birth to Jesus and laid him in the manger. Do you know what a manger is?
Sure, it's like a trough that animals.
Where do we usually find troughs that animals
can have? In barns.
What's an animal made for a barn?
Stable.
Someone has to own a stable.
Yeah! Yeah!
This is who I'm calling innkeeper. He was the owner of the place where Mary and Joseph stayed when Jesus was born.
Right, he has a story of the Savior. He didn't know that by telling Mary and Joseph that they couldn't stay in this, that they could stay in this stable, that he was giving housing to the Son of God. Wow, what a thought.
Yes, he was able to provide a place for the one and only Savior, and he didn't even know it.
Oh,
shepherd's story also fits in.
In the same region, there were some shepherds.
Who was there? How many shepherds were there?
I don't know.
Staying out in the fields and keeping over their watch from their flock at night. And an angel of the Lord suddenly stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terribly frightened. But the angel said to them,
"Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy, which will be for all the people. For today, in the city of David, there has been born for you a Savior who is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger."
Luke chapter 2, verses 8 through 12. And suddenly there appeared with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts, praising God and saying,
"Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among men to whom he is pleased."
When the angels had gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds began saying to one another,
"Let us go straight to Bethlehem
just to see the thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us."
Thank you.
Spirit into the temple. And when the parents brought in the child Jesus to carry out the customs of the law, then he took him into his arms and blessed God and said,
"Now, Lord, you are releasing your bondservant to perform to you."
In peace according to your word. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the presence of all peoples, a light of revelation to the Gentiles and glory of your people Israel.
Luke chapter 2, verses 27
through 32. He was actually able to hold the Savior in his arms.
Finally, we will tell you about Anna. She was a publican who was interesting for the Lord with all who was listening.
She was a ready servant of the Lord, and her story is one we shall keep all, that we should all keep close to our heart.
Luke chapter 2, verses 36 through 38.
There are so many people who have a story of the Savior.
What's your story?
I wanted to share with y'all that thank you for bringing thank you for bringing your kids to church. Because people need Jesus, people need church. Because we live in a society and a world that's attacking our kids, attacking our families, and attacking the family period. And keep bringing those kids. Bring yourself. Don't just drop your kids off. Come, get plugged in, and see what God can do through you like He's done through these kids tonight, okay? But thank you for bringing them and sharing them with us, because they've been a blessing to me, and I'm sure they've been a blessing to everybody else that's worked with them. So, right now, I am going to close us in prayer, and I'm also going to bless the food, because we got some food. Everybody stay seated once I pray, and we'll give you some directions. We got a bunch of people, and that's a praise. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. But everybody's going to get fed. We got a bunch of food, so there's no need to rush the line. There's plenty. So let's go to the Lord in prayer. Dear Lord, we thank you once again for this night. Thank you for this time. Thank you for them kids. And Lord, we thank you for Jesus, the Savior of the world. And Lord, I pray that if somebody in this room that don't have that greatest gift, which is the Savior, Lord, that they will confess their sin, believe, and just proclaim you as their Lord. And Lord, I pray as we come together in fellowship with one another, and as we break bread and as we eat food together, I pray you bless the fellowship, bless the food to our bodies, and our bodies to your service. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.